Welcome back to the channel. We continue to learn Power BI, and in today's video, we are going to show you how to make a histogram so that you can see the number of products sold in different bin sizes so that you can see which products have sales, which products are selling more of in a quantity. And this only requires a couple of measures that we're going to be making. We're going to set up the bins, and then we're going to round up those bins so that you can adjust those sizes of the bins. Creating a histogram, this is if you're doing data analysis. Remember, you can download the file in the description below and follow along. We're going to walk you through step by step how to build a histogram in Power BI. Back in Power BI, when you're doing analysis of a data set, sometimes you want to look for patterns, and you also want to see a data distribution of sales. In this video, we are going to show you how to make this histogram chart. There currently is not a histogram available in your visual gallery inside Power BI, but you can take an existing visual, make some changes, add a couple of measures, and we're going to show you how to make this. What this tells me at a glance is that we have 62 products that have sold between 0 and 100. We have 91 products that have sold between 91 and 200, and 88 products have sold 200 and 300. Now, in the product table, we do have, if you go to the data table view, we have 397 products. And what this histogram gives in the report view is a breakdown of those sales. So we're going to show you how to create this histogram in Power BI. You can download the file and follow along in Power BI. It's the AdventureWorks DW2020 file. There will be a link in the description below so that you can download the file. Once you open up the file, you are going to create a new page. We are going to rename this page Histogram. Next, we need to see how this file is set up. If you're new to the AdventureWorks database file, it is completely set up with your model view. We have a fact table that is sales. We also have some lookup tables, and those lookup tables include sales territory, customer, sales order. We do have a product table. So we have a product table that lists all the products. We have a sales table that lists all the sales. The product table is connected to the sales table by the product key. So the first thing we're going to want to do when we go to the report view is we're going to want to go to the sales table, and we see if we go to the table view in the sales table, we see that we have a product key. Each product has a key. So we are going to want to calculate the number of product that have sales, because some of these products do not have sales. So in the sales table, we're going to create a new measure called number of sales orders. And what this will allow us to do is make our bins in the product table. So the calculation is we're going to count the number of rows, and we're going to use the related table. The related table goes to another table, and it's asking for the table. So the table is sales. So now we have, we're going to count the number of rows in sales that have the sales orders. So this way, when we go back to our product table, we can now start to make the bins that we will need. In the product table, we need to add a column. So we currently have all of these different columns in the product table, and we're going to do one formula to create the sales order bins. And this is going to be a new column. It's going to be called sales order bins. And what we're going to do is bring in with a left bracket the number of sales orders. So we're going to close this off, and this shows us the number of sales orders in each of those bins. So now that we see by product, and each product has a product key. So the first one, 210 HL Road Frames, they do not have any product sales in this database. But if we look at product number 256, we have an LL Road Frame. We can see that it has one product sale. So if you filter by 256, we will see that if we have one product in the product table, then if we go to the sales table and we look at the product key, if we select 256, we see that we have one sale. And that is how we match up the total number of sales. So now we want to clear those filters. We're going to clear the filter in the sales table. We go up to the product table and we clear the filter on the product key. So now we know we've got the right number, but we can't have a bunch of bins for every single increment of sales. So what we want to do is round down. So now we want to add on to our sales order bins. We want to go back in there and we want to use the round down function. And the round down asks for a number, and the number is going to come from the number of sales orders. Now we just need to work on the digits, and we want to round down -2, and that will round us down to 100, 200, 300. Anything less than 100 will go to 0. So now we're going to round down, and you see our sales order bins now start to have that 200, 300, 0, 2400. So now we can actually start to make the visual and then work on the formatting of the visual in the bins. We have now created our sales order bins, and we've rounded them down to the nearest 100. Now it's time to make our actual visual, and then we're going to create it and turn it into a histogram. Starting off from the data visualization gallery, we do not have a histogram visual. So we are going to choose the clustered column chart. We're going to make this a little bit bigger. Then we're going to start to add. So the first thing when you build this out is on the x-axis, that is where you want to have your product sales order bins. So we're going to add the data from the product table, and we want to have the sales order bins. Now we're going to go to the y-axis, and the y-axis will be the count. So when we add in from the sales table, it's going to be the number of sales orders. So now we have the basic of the start of our histogram. A couple of things before we start to build out this visual. Under the sales order bins, you want to make sure that this is a whole number under the column tools, and then you want to don't summarize, because you don't want to summarize those number of bins. So we have our bins, and now for the bins, since we have 397 products, and a lot of those products, if you notice, don't have any sales, we only want to look at when it's less than 600. So we're going to filter and apply that filter. So now we see our bins. Now, the next thing we're going to want to do is we are going to want to go to the number of continuing to work on our histogram. Now we have the bins set up. Now we want to work on actual formatting this out. If you notice in our more options, we cannot sort this by the axis. That is missing. And reason why that is missing is we need to go into our building a visual options into our x-axis, and we need to change this type from a continuous to a categorical. Now we can go back to our more options. We can sort the axis by the bins. And next, we can sort this in ascending. So now we're starting to build this out. And then we're just going to want to clean up some of the features on the visual. If you go to the x-axis under the formatting, we're going to want to turn off the title. And then if you go to the y-axis, we're going to want to turn off the title. We're going to want to turn off the values. We're going to on the y-axis. So now it's starting to come a little bit better. On the x-axis, remember, which is the scale going from the bottom, we're going to want to make this a little bit easier to read. So we're going to make the values 12 point, so that'll make it bigger. And then on the x-axis, we are going to, we could change the color. Let's just go. But one of the things we do want to do is check out and make sure that we have the labels on. We're almost completed the histogram. We just have a couple of changes. Now this file in the AdventureWorks file, one of the things is that in the sales table, if you go to the sales table and you go to the table view, currently the product key is hidden. And we need to show that so that we can bring that. Now you notice a little eyeball goes away. So now when we go back to our sales table, we can delete the y-axis, bring in the product key to the y-axis, and rather than have a count, we need to do a distinct count. And now we have those labels. Under the y-axis, we can add on the data labels. And if we want to make them a little bit bigger, we could do that as well. So for the data labels, we're going to from 9-point to 14-point. And what this tells us is that we have between 0 and 100, we have 62 products in that bucket. We have 91 products between 100 and 200. And then between 200 and 300, we have 88 products. When you go to your product table, we see that the breakdown of products is we have 350 distinct product keys. So that is how you make a histogram. You're going to want to use some data analysis. It allows you to look at some distributions in your data set. And a lot of times you make a histogram in Excel. So now that when you're in Power BI and you're analyzing a data set, you can make those same histograms starting off with a bar chart. Remember, you can download the file in the description below and follow along. And the key final step is to show those values in the sales table, the product keys, so that you can get the buckets to show and then change them to a distinct count. That is a look at histograms in Power BI.